Thank you very much indeed, and it's wonderful to be here to present the final result from a very exciting study that we did in regional Victoria using this new digital app called Pulsar, which I'm sure many of you have probably heard about. So when you're coming to hospital, you want things to happen quickly. You want to leave the fast lane, you want to get in and into hospital, you want things to work, and this is not what you want to encounter. Chaos, dysfunction, and things just falling over all over the place. And as many of you are aware, you're on the front line, this is what we do encounter from time to time. What we really need is this, something to work really smoothly and to be incredibly patient-focused. Everything that we do in the pre-hospital and early hospital stages, we want focused and directed around the patient. And what you maybe can't appreciate from this slide is that they're all wearing helmets for the obvious reason, but in those helmets there are actually communication tools. So they're actually talking to each other the whole time. So the patient, the car, is at the centre of their attention. And this is really important because when we're talking about STEMI, when we're talking about time, a stroke, it's all about time. Time is muscle and time is brain. And we really have no time to lose when we're treating these two conditions. Now, the problem at the hospital end is that we tend to work in silos. As you can see from here, there's the EMS. They do their little bit, and then the next group may come along, which may be some of the resus team or registration team. Then maybe neurology, maybe cardiology get involved. And then, of course, if you have to transfer between hospitals, it's a whole new ballgame altogether. So we do have a problem of working in silos in our hospitals. And this is inevitably what happens. We have random communication, and there's phone calls, there's texts. Sometimes, heaven forbid, in this day and age, there's even bits of paper floating around. It's random, and it's not really coordinated, and again, it's not focused on the patient. So with this in mind, about 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, we started a study at two hospitals in regional Victoria, in Ballarat and Bendigo, utilising this pre-hospital stroke tool. As you can see, it has a number of different modules in it, STEMI, cardiac arrest, stroke, trauma, sepsis and general. But for this particular study, we very much focused on acute stroke and acute STEMI, and using this pre-hospital tool to help coordinate and fine-tune the care of these patients as they move from the pre-hospital to the hospital environment. So what actually happens? Well, this is obviously a cardiac case. The paramedics turn up at the scene and they have the app loaded on their phone or could be on a tablet, and they start entering vitals. And you can see down here there's an area for entry of vitals. They then assess the patient, and they can either do the ECG before or in the ambulance. And the good news is that as they're doing this, they're also able to get a lot of additional data. So you can see I've highlighted the images there. They can take a photo of a driver's license, of a utilities bill. They can take a photo of a medication list. And all that information is then able to be communicated. When they're either in the home or in the back of the ambulance, they can have their ECG done, and with the Zoll devices, that's now automatically uploaded into the Pulsar app. So that, again, can be transferred to the hospital very rapidly. So then the paramedics arrive at the hospital, and as you can see, again, we have the ECG now preloaded. We have all those other images I talked about preloaded. And as you can see, in this particular cardiac case, the communication has gone directly through to the cath lab, and the cath lab is able to respond and say we're ready. So we've really got a situation where work in the pre-hospital environment is going deep into the hospital and alerting the cath lab that a STEMI case is coming in. Once they go to the cath lab, they can then be treated, and that can be finalised by either the treating clinician or maybe the registrar, as you can see here. And the stop STEMI button is hit, and the case is stood down. So when they're in the field and they're hitting that alert button, the iPad or other tablet that goes off in the emergency department has a loud siren. It cannot be avoided. It's absolutely unavoidable. And the ED staff are able to bring in extra team members as they see fit into a particular case. So there's constantly alerts going off in all the different departments, be it ED, be it in the cath lab, or in this particular case, you can see this is a stroke patient coming in. There's an alert here that the CT scan is ready. And as you can see, again, we have the vital signs and images uploaded. But as you can see, this is a stroke case. And one of the key things in acute stroke treatment is that we want to know what is the last time the patient was known to be well, because that's going to determine whether we can give thrombolysis, whether we can do endovascular clot retrieval. And this particular case was a stroke, so it's gone through to the CT scanner. And you can see here that the radiographer has a tablet on the desk with the Pulsar app loaded with all those stroke details available. And the other thing you can see here is that we have a lot of metrics that are recorded all the way through this. Lots of times, and you can see that there's a goal for treatment. And then there's the average that's being achieved, and obviously you want to push the blue line as close to the green line as possible. So again, this is a deep communication tool, but the really important thing about this is it closes the loop. So it goes back to the paramedic, and rather than waiting a month later when there's an audit done of all cases and finding out what happened to that patient on Thursday afternoon, you actually get immediate feedback, and you can see what happened to the case, and you can tap in further, and you can actually get a complete summary of what that patient's treatment was. So there is immediate feedback to the paramedics. So Pulsara is operational extensively across the USA. It's in 400 hospitals and EMS services, 21 states. They've treated well over 150,000 cases now. It's HIPAA compliant, it's Australian privacy principles compliant with very secure data transfer. So this particular study, the research aim was to determine if the Pulsara digital communication app can improve care timelines for patients with STEMI and stroke. It was operational in two hospitals, in Bendigo and Ballarat in regional Victoria. We had 25 ambulance sites. There was a phone in each ambulance, which we actually bought for the ambulances. But within a matter of a few weeks, the paramedics quickly realised you could load this on your own phone, and they promptly did so. So we are very much now in the era of BYOD, bring your own device, and that's continued to this day. We did a lot of Pulsara training at the base, in the hospital, in the ambulance services, and in the ambulance stations as well. And on site at Bendigo and Ballarat hospitals, we had on site project coordinators. We had two iPads in the ED and triage area. Those images that I showed you of the driver's license or the utilities bill, that goes through to the triage desk where there's an iPad, and they can actually bring up all the patient's details of their history in the hospital. So it's all ready to go when the ambulance actually rolls in. And of course, we had one in radiology in the CT area and in the cath lab, the cardiac cath lab. And in the hospital, all the clinical staff used their own devices, and we did a lot of on-site training in the hospital and got the Pulsara team out from the US to help us do that. So the clinical evaluation was a pre-post control design, so 12 months prior to Pulsara commencing and 12 months after the commencement of Pulsara. We looked at patients with suspected stroke or STEMI, and that was as assessed by the ED clinicians or the paramedics, and we did data verification with the VACIS database and a hospital medical record audit. So the sort of data we collected was obviously mainly in terms of times, whether the Pulsar app was used or whether it wasn't used. A lot of paramedic metrics, scene to hospital arrival, to triage, to off-stretcher times, and a lot of hospital metrics as well. Door to medical review, door to PCI, door to balloon times. We did statistical analysis with Crystal Wallace statistics, looking at times to assessment and treatment treatment between groups, and chi-squared, looking at proportion of patients receiving treatment. So, now to the results. So over this time period, we had 604 stroke cases and 247, suspected stroke cases and 240 STEMIs. As you can see, in terms of age and sex, there was no significant differences between the groups. The STEMI cases are in black, the stroke cases are in red, and there was no significant differences between the two groups. In terms of the paramedic metrics, on the hospital loaded to arrival at hospital, so patient loaded to arrival at hospital, you can see that for STEMI, there was a use of Pulsara resulted in a reduction of 21 minutes. Use of Pulsara reduction in it resulted in a reduction of 4 minutes for acute stroke. From patient arrival at hospital to triage, for STEMI, there was a reduction of 3 minutes. For stroke, 4 minutes. Patient arrival at hospital to off stretcher, 5 minutes for STEMI and 8 minutes for stroke. So consistently improvements across both groups at the hospital end. Now looking at hospital-based metrics, door to first medical review. For STEMI, that was reduced by 1 minute, for stroke by 17 minutes. For door-to-balloon time for PCI, there was a reduction in 17 minutes, small numbers we should add. But when we looked at the reduction in or improvement in the number of cases treated within 90 minutes, which is one of the cardiac guidelines, we saw an improvement from 50% treated within 90 minutes up to 78% treated within 90 minutes. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in a moment. Looking at those stroke cases, when we looked at door to CT time, that's for all strokes, that was about 300 cases. We saw a reduction in door to CT time of 44 minutes. For door to needle time for the TPA cases, and that was about 50 cases, all cases in fact ended up using Pulsara, and they had a door to needle time of 78 minutes, which was excellent for a regional hospital. Importantly, again, the treatment time under 60 minutes for stroke, it's what we call the golden hour, and we saw a more than twofold increase in the number of patients being able to receive stroke thrombolysis under 60 minutes, up to 26%. So, in conclusion, the use of Pulsara resulted in faster ambulance hospital arrival time to triage time by about 3 to 4 minutes. Faster ambulance hospital arrival to off-stretcher times by between 5 to 8 minutes. Faster door-to-balloon times for primary PCR by 17 minutes. But the interesting thing is that PCI under 90 minutes, with the use of Pulsara, in other words, use of a pre-hospital notification tool, we achieved a 78% treatment rate. And this is compared to VCOR, which is the Victorian Cardiac Outcomes Registry, which measures PCI outcomes across the whole state of Victoria. Their below 90-minute rate is 77%. So you can see that Pulsara in a regional hospital is able to achieve what is able to be achieved in metro, basically metro hospitals in Melbourne. So they're virtually identical. The interesting thing about the VCOR data, however, is that when you look at the data broken down into whether or not there was pre-hospital notification, you can see there was a significant difference. So if in the metro hospitals there was pre-notification of a STEMI coming in, then without pre-hospital notification, only 64% got treated, which should have been the other way around. But if there is pre-hospital notification, 87% are able to be treated. So clearly, in a metro hospital, they demonstrated if you have pre-hospital notification, you get very good treatment rates. But as you would expect, if there's no pre-hospital notification, then the treatment rates for STEMI diminish. For stroke, we had a reduction of 44 minutes in the door to CT times. We had an overall TPA rate of 35%, which is excellent. The national average in regional hospitals is 23%, and in metro is 31%. So with using Pulsara, these regional hospitals were able to achieve treatment rates that are equivalent to metro hospitals. And in both Ballarat and Bendigo hospitals now, Pulsara is used for all acute stroke and STEMI cases. The interesting thing was the qualitative aspects that have come out of this. So I presented a lot of metrics, a lot of quantitative data, but there was a lot of qualitative benefits that came out of using Pulsara. It was quickly determined that Pulsara really did provide a streamlined, real-time communication for the entire patient care journey. And I haven't sort of highlighted some of the other elements of Pulsara, which is that you can communicate back and forth with the paramedics using the Pulsara app. So there's real-time communication, particularly if there's a change in the patient's condition. All personnel have exactly the same information. It's all there on the screen in front of you. And there was a significant impact in terms of the need to having to repeat information because everyone had the same details there. There was incredible transparency and feedback, and the paramedics were really impressed with the fact that they could get an almost instantaneous feedback as to the outcome of the patient. And the other interesting thing was the ability to pre-register the patient before they actually arrived in hospital. And that brought about significant reduction in delays when the paramedic arrived at the receiving hospital. So this, of course, has been a study with many people involved, led by myself and, in particular, my co-investigators, Dr. Kath Baggett, who did an amazing amount of work on this with Professor Dominic Cadillac, Stephen Bernard and Michelle Vu. And I just want to highlight our fabulous paramedics and team leaders, particularly Wayne Pearce and Howard Hall from Loddon Mallee and Grant Hocking from the Grampians region, plus Simon Vendian. Simon may even be here today, I'm not sure, and Danielle North, who really were fantastic in providing leadership in getting this project up and running. Thank you.